Hey folks, Robert from Fishing in South Okanagan. Today we are ice fishing on the beautiful Yellow Lake. Woo! It is February 23rd, beautiful day, and let's catch some perch, a little bit of trout, and let's see if any kokanee are home. Hope you're excited just as much as I am. Getting much ice fishing in as possible before all the ice melts. So, even though people have left their logs for a fire, I guess that's structure for some fish. But let's check it out and see what we come up with. You know folks, the one thing that I'm going to show you today is with your auger. Now even though mine is gas auger, I've seen quite a few guys take their manual auger and smack it into the ice and pretty much you dent your blades like that. Don't be an idiot. Don't do that. Be smart. Just put it down, start augering your ice hole. And you don't have to put up with a bent blade whatsoever. Same thing goes with a manual one, even though it does have look like it's an ice pick, but still you wouldn't want to do that because if one wrong move and it's bent, your day is done. So folks, this is my ice auger, handed down to me by my uncle when he picked up a new, I think it was Eskimo power auger. Had many good memories with this. I can remember the first time taking this out to this exact lake, and all the bolts on this here, on the chassis, came apart, and pretty much I had no other bolts whatsoever. It went down the hole, gone forever. So what I ended up having to do is take the strings off of this and tie it to the one of these holes that already lost bolt and nut, and pretty much use it as best as I could. Next day I was pretty smart, went out to the local hardware store and matched up the holes and nuts for this, and found the nuts with the plastic inside of them so they don't move. And now I have more spares at home, ready to go. So right now, if, I don't know if you can hear that, that was the ice moving around underneath. Hopefully that doesn't come a problem, but let's wait and see. Okay. Temperamental, folks. But I still love her. Well, folks, this Christmas, my loving wife was very gracious and kind to me and picked me this up for Christmas. Boy, was I ever happy. I've always wanted one of these things. Now I have it. Alright folks, so today's setup, again, I'm using the Fenwick Aetos light, medium light action rod. Had a lot of success on this. On the line, I have leftover, I think it was 50 pound braid. I know that's a bit much, but it was extra and I didn't want to spend any more money on the line. Along with a ice fishing fluorocarbon leader. I think it's 8 pound test, which pretty much blue in color, pretty much dissolves in the water, and all the fish see is the lure. Now again, I do have my wire leader on here again. This thing is money, absolute money. It's medium light. I do have ultralight on there as well. I haven't had a chance to use that one yet, but I've had a lot of success on the medium light wire bobber. I think I got this one at either Cabela's. Yeah, it was probably Cabela's because Bass Pro Shop doesn't carry much ice fishing stuff. Well, they do, but not to my satisfaction. But I'm going to change up the lure, this lure, to a white wire maggot looking hook, and if I'm not mistaken, I do believe I have it in here. Yes, I do. It's that one right there. I don't know if you can see it much. That one right there. And, a lot of my friends that have used that lure have had a lot of success, so we'll see what happens. But that's my tackle box. These guys right here are so much fun to catch fish on. Those are the Northland's tungsten larvae fly. And those are absolutely money. I was so excited when I was online just cruising the web and found those ones, and I'm like, holy smokes. Also looking forward to the VMC tungsten fly as well. They have those out there as well. Almost similar to the Northlands ones. But yeah, I'll have to wait and see when they arrive. So I'm gonna change up my lure here, get on some bait, and let's go fishing. Let's get you closer to the action. You know, this, folks, this is a good situation for ice fishing. You got a bucket. Also have one of the foam seats that I picked up at a local fishing store, and that was a big help. Was on the fence with the cushy one because chances are when I get off of it, or if I actually kick the bucket, it's gonna fall down. So this one that I'm sitting on right now snaps to a 5 gallon pail. Easy peasy, and you got yourself a nice warm seat. So the depth I'm at right now is 9.3 feet. And no one home just yet, even though there's something dancing on the bottom, but I'm sure that's just the sensitivity of the flasher. Before the battery dies on the camera, here's what I'll show you. So as you can see, that's your top, that's your bottom. And anything between there is pretty much a fish. The sensitivity on this is phenomenal. It's a Showdown Troller 2.0. They also make the 5.6, which is a little bit larger version of the... flasher. Sorry, folks, I had to swallow there for a sec. Now again, I do apologize for my tardiness of adding more videos. It has been a while. Just been busy with other things. For those that have stuck around and been with me since day one, I thank you. What else I can say, you know? I'm only human. So the knot I'm tying on this wire hook, that one right there. You know, funny story, folks, with this hook here, I actually have some old copper ones that my uncle gave me when I was a kid, and we caught whitefish in Wabamum, Alberta, and a few other lakes I can't remember, but the wire ones tipped with a minnow did very, very well. Now the knot I'm tying on this hook is I like a clinch knot. If it's a small hole, I'll go with a clinch knot. If it's a bigger hole, if I feel up to it, I'll do a Pelham or knot. But right now I'm going to do a clinch knot. And whoops, slippery little line. Now usually the turns I do is a lucky seven. You know, I guess maybe I'm a little bit superstitious being an angler. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Then hold, what I like to do is hold your fingers on the line twist so it doesn't get away on you. Bring your tag end that you stuck the eye through, bring it back to over here, to that loop there. And then stick the tag end that you just put down here into that loop. And like so. Come on, get in there. All right, it's in there. Now it's got to complete it. There we go. Now before you cinch the knot, wet it with your own saliva. Oop, get back in there. And what this saliva does is causes less friction of your line to make your knot a little bit stronger. And then bring it all the way down, and there you have it. You have your clinch knot. Just be careful when you go and tighten the knot on top that your fingers don't slip and get yourself pierced by the hook. And then either use your scissors or these Rapala clippers and cut the tag end off. Just maybe about, pardon me, an eighth. Later. Now you have your hook. What I end up like doing is bring the knot over like that, and then when the hook hangs like that, it looks like something going vertical instead of going up and down. So the choice of bait that I like to use, and I've tried plastics last year, was very unsuccessful, unfortunately. I was looking forward to catching something on soft plastic during the winter time, but just wasn't the case. I learned my lesson, and now I use shrimp. The shrimp that you want to use is the cooked shrimp that you find at supermarkets or in the seafood section. Don't pick up the canned shrimp whatsoever. That stuff will fall apart once it hits your hook. It does not stay on whatsoever. So what you do, and what I like to do, is break off just an itty bitty piece. Do not ingest these things whatsoever, because chances are if you leave them behind in the car or in your tackle bag, it doesn't get too yummy. You get food poisoning. So that's a little piece right there of the shrimp. Or if you want, you can take more time and cut it about maybe your first finger knuckle, give or take, and put it in a container and put the smelly jelly liquid of craw in there, nice to marinate, and which I believe I've had success with the trout and perch, just love that stuff. So put it on like that. And there you go. Now, the more bait you put on there kind of acts like a lead weight or a tungsten weight on your line, and gets the thing down there faster, or the lure down there faster. So, ooh, that was a good one. Set up the wire bobber, and oh yeah. One thing always to remember is the reel handle. When you're going fishing, you're all ready to go, and all of a sudden your line is down and forgot to set your handle to the proper extension. Now, when holding your rod, what I end up like doing is, come on, punch through there. Let's go. Is holding the rod like this, and the reason I do so is the simple fact you get better hook set. If you hold it here and you bring your rod all the way up here, you can't really much get a good hook set. But if you hold it like this, you pretty much can jig properly, and your hook sets are a lot better than the traditional way of holding your spinning rod. Here, let me show you how this works. So, as you can see, those lines at the top are just interference, and that thing moving up and down on the bottom near the 10 digit mark is my lure. And when a fish comes, pretty much all it is one line that comes to pass. And when I see the line come, all I do is now pay attention on my rod or even the wire bobber to see if there's going to be any bites. Another thing to remember that I just reminded myself of is when you're ice fishing, best thing to do is give yourself maybe 6 inches, give or take, off the bottom. Or if you're fishing for perch, I guess from what I understand, the best way if you have a muddy bottom is pound the dirt to make up a fuss. And which probably works, I haven't done it yet. And we have ourselves a trout. See? Ooh, whoa. Hang on. Whoa, hang on. Whoa. Okay. Slippery little sucker. Okay, open the gill. Well, since it's being a slippery little sucker, there we go. Nice little trout. Thank you. So yesterday went to Trout Lake, which is over that way. Only got one sniff, which sucks because I was looking forward to catching some good perch over there. Caught that fish around 11:45. Late getting here. Goodness sakes. I left my stopwatch on. Whoops. Another thing I like to do is if you have a watch or cell phone, set yourself a goal of maybe 5 minutes or however you want to fish your ice fishing hole. If nothing's happening within that 5 minutes, move on. If something is happening, maybe give yourself another 5 minutes in that hole. It's always a good feeling to have it first underneath your belt for the day. Here, let me show you what doing here. So when ice fishing, you can either dead stick it, which is staying still like this, and I find that the how sensitive your rod is, your own heartbeat is pretty much moving the lure itself along with the current of the water as well. And you can do a countdown or however you may choose.